Hello everybody, welcome to the session on isometric projection. Myself Sendhil, professor of Mekongu Engineering College. So let us see the problem. The problem here is a pentagonal pyramid base 30 mm and height 70 mm stands with its base on HP and edge of the base is parallel to VP and nearer to it. A section plane cuts the pyramid at 30 degree incline to HP and passes through a point on the axis at a distance of 20 mm from the apex. So draw the isometric view of the truncated pyramid. So here let us see the starting of a top view. So here a pentagonal pyramid and they give an edge of the base is parallel to VP and nearer to it. So when you are talking about the top view here, there are three chances for it. So either the top view will be like this or like this or like this. So when you are talking about these three options, in this first option we hear a base edge is not parallel, it is perpendicular to the VP, right? So it is wrong. And when you coming to the second option, here the base edge is parallel but it is not nearer to it, so this is also wrong. Then you come to the third option, so here your base edge is parallel to VP and it is nearer to it. So this will be your correct option and this is the one which you are going to start with. So as usual, let us start with the top view. Okay, so here base edge is 30 mm, so I have drawn a base edge with the 30 mm top view and I completed the pyramid. So name all the edges here. Then project the top view towards the front view onto the vertical plane, whereas the here the height of your pyramid is 70 mm, and name the edges, base edges and the apex. Okay, now so here the section plane is given as it passes through a point 20 mm from the apex. So measure 20 mm, mark a point and on this point draw a section plane which is 30 degree with your HP. Okay, now plot all the section points accordingly. Now plot your section points, project your section points onto the top view so that we will be getting the sectional top view. So from one we'll be getting the, from one dash we'll be getting the point 1 along the slant edge OA. So in order to get the point 2, since the section point 2 is lying on the same vertical line, we need to have a line along OA from which we can project the point 2 onto it and get the section point 2 here. So this will be a point 2. So similarly, project all the points 3, 4 and 5 onto the respective slant edges and plot the section points on the top view. Now connect all the section points to get the sectional top view. So let us highlight all the other remaining portion of the solid in the top view and hatch the top view. So this will be your required sectional top view here. Okay, so now we have to transfer these into an isometric view. So what I'm gonna do now is, first I'll be enclosing this top view with a quadrilateral. So here I'm naming the quadrilaterals PQRS. So this is the quadrilateral upon which I'll be building my isometric view. Okay, so now transfer this onto the isometric view. So to start your isometric view, draw a horizontal line and mark a point, either P or Q or S, either any point we can take. But here, since here section plane is here in this direction, so it is always advisable to choose a point which is aligned towards the sectional plane. So here P is the one which is aligned towards the section plane. So it is advisable to first pick a point P here. So whenever transferring all the points to the sectional view, it must be represented in capital letters. So from point P, draw the lines Q and S, that is PQ and PS, at an inclination of 30 degree with your reference horizontal line. So this is the way in which you have to start your isometric view. So then complete your box here, that is your PQRS. Okay, now along these boxes transfer all these points accordingly with the similar length ratio. Okay, so I have transferred all the points, that is with between P and S it is A, and between P and Q B. Similarly, I have measured everything and I have transferred and I have given the base here. So the base has been drawn. Okay, now what I'm going to do is now plot the center here and mark the axis height accordingly to the given value, that is 70 mm. So that will be your point O. Now connect all your base points with your apex point here. Okay, so next what I'm going to do is, next is the very critical point. Everyone must listen carefully here. So I have to transfer these points 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, which I am seeing it here in the top view, onto the base here. So in order to transfer it, I will be following a simple methodology, that is a relative positioning. So from P, so the point 1 is at a distance of X, you can measure it. Okay, and similarly from point P, the 1 is at a distance of Y. So along these two axes I can measure the dimension for point 1, and accordingly I can transfer it to the isometric view like this. So X and Y are all the same value which I had transferred from here to here. Okay, so now the points at which this two lines meet will be your 1 dash. Okay, so here the second points here which I got are on only on the base, so I am marking it as 1 1. Okay, then similarly your point 2 3 4 and 5 are achieved. So from point 2 is achieved like this. Okay, so this line, measure the distance and get the point here. Similarly your point 3 can be received or can be achieved through the relative dimensioning from Q like this. So from Q, what is the distance, and mark the point. Similarly your 4, okay, and similarly your 5. So all the points I can take. So I have received all your, transferred all your section points from the top view to the base of your isometric view. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, next step is very simple. Just extend all these points vertically upwards so that it cuts their respective slant edges. So your point 1 1, your section point 1 1 has to cut the edge OA. So extend it vertically upwards so that it cuts your slant edge OA at point 1. Similarly your 2 has to cut your slant edge OB at. Similarly, 3 has to cut your slant edge OC at 3. Similarly, your 4 and 5. Right? So, all these lines are drawn vertically upwards till the point at which it meets their respective slant edges. Now, connect all your section points with a darker pencil and highlight the remaining solid. So, this will be your truncated solids isometric view and hatch the sectioned area. So this view gives the isometric view of a truncated pyramid. So if you want to make it as a projection while transferring the points from here onto the isometric view, you have to multiply it by 0.82. So that will be giving you the isometric projection. Okay, thank you.